Hello, my name is Dexy, and I have just learned a valuable lesson. Well, several lessons, really. The first has to do with fair compensation. Apparently, it's a concept that doesn't mean the same thing to everyone. You see, I'm something of a freelance writer. I just finished writing an article for an underground progressive techno newsletter. This man, who calls himself Escape Pod, is the editor-in-chief.
Fan-freaking-tastic, Dexy. Look, I can't pay you. At least not in money, anyways.
So you mean like a gift card, or...?
In a way. What do we agree on for this?
200.
You like fans, Dexy? That baby over there goes for $249.95. But guess what? I can't fit it in the old office.
Escape Pod, I really would prefer in this instance...
It's yours. Here's the receipt.
Escape Pod. This is unacceptable. You know, I am,
Get your fan out of my yard, Dexy.
But, no, yeah. I'm...
Go on, get out of here.
The second lesson? If you're gonna transport a ceiling fan, it is most unwise to use a bicycle. I know it's kind of a obvious lesson, but, still worth mentioning, I think. So good, isn't it? Sweet tea? It is truly a beacon of refreshment in an otherwise harsh and unforgiving world. Well, that's about it. You know the exposition, so if you'll excuse me, I have one hell of a whole lot of walking to do if I'm going to get to Bed Bath & Beyond before it closes. Nice fan!
Yeah, nice and heavy, isn't it? But I don't have to tell you that.
So what are you, crazy or something? Why are you walking around town with a ceiling fan?
Well, it's a lot safer than biking around with a fan, for starters. You think Bed Bath & Beyond will let me return this without a receipt?
No, you've got to have a receipt. Wait a minute.
Do you have a receipt?
How the hell do you know that I have a receipt?
It's easy. You just look like a guy who isn't satisfied with his fan and is in the position to do something about it.
Oh, I get it. You're one of those intuitive guys.
I don't know about that. I just wanted a sip of your iced tea.
Actually, it's sweet tea. They're not necessarily the same thing.
Tastes like iced tea to me. Thanks a million.
Okay, that was weird. The guy back there? You know, I bet if this were like a different kind of story, he would turn out to be some manifestation of a repressed aspect of my psyche. But, you know, I don't think that's what's going on here. I can be pretty intuitive myself, you know. I think he might have taken the receipt.
How could this have happened, you may be wondering? It must have occurred right there. Did you see that? Right there. Yeah. He took advantage of my willingness to share the glorious symphony of flavor that rings out in every carton of sweet tea. Oh, how could I have been so gullible?
Okay. Normally I would be yelling out all kinds of, like, profanity right now. But because that is an elementary school, I will try to refrain from doing so. Okay, no problem. This is fine. I'm just gonna have to get to Bed Bath & Beyond very, very quickly now, excuse me. Let's go. Probably wondering why I'm sitting here in the woods instead of chasing after that guy. Let me explain. As you know, the shortest distance between any two points is a straight line, otherwise known as a vector in, scientific circles. I have been traveling along one such vector en route to Bed Bath & Beyond, which is just through these woods here, ensuring that I will get there first in time to intercept and... Did you hear that?
Ah! Well, well. Hell of a hike, wasn't it? Sure made good time, didn't you?
I did. It was important that I get here without delay or hesitation. Do you know why?
That's easy. It's because you think I stole your little receipt, and you want it back.
Ha ha! Very good! Wow! However did you intuit that one?
Quite simple. I am a figment of your imagination.
What?
I said, I exist only in your mind.
No. No, you don't.
And why not? You live in a dream world. The only way for you to see the truth is to dream up someone like me to show it to you.
No. No, that is not what this is.
And why not? You have doubts about your future as a writer? Think you aren't qualified to do anything else? You just carried a ceiling fan across town. You're hanging by a thread.
No, I'm not! Give me back my receipt!
Forget the receipt. It's gone. Go home and make something of yourself.
Oh my God, you're absolutely right.
Of course I'm right. Quit carrying the ceiling fan. It's degrading. Go home and apply to law school. There's nothing wrong with dreaming unless it blinds us from the truth.
I suspected that drinking the tea would result in an apotheosis of the Joseph Campbell variety. That is a critical moment of the story where the character's perception of reality is dramatically changed.
What is this?
Green tea with mango-flavored ginseng and honey? I knew it! Receipt. Gary J. Fenelack of 2336 Bensonia Avenue in Dormont, figment of my subconscious indeed.
Well, maybe that's the name of your inner self.
Oh, please. Here, take your disgusting tea. Dude, what did you do? Go back home and change your clothes to freak me out? And another thing, I am thrilled that someone would want to give me a ceiling fan in exchange for my writing. So, you know, maybe I am satisfied with it. I hope you're satisfied with yours. There's some lesson to be learned from all of that. Several lessons, maybe. What they all are, I'm not sure. You never really see all the angles until you reach the end of the journey. So, I'll figure it out eventually. It's a work in progress.
You're killing me, escape pod! You know that? It's unprofessional.
Damn it. This deep day's terrible. But I can't stop freaking it.
Phone interrogator? Yeah, man. Dude, this new beat I made, I literally cannot stop listening to it. I hear it in my sleep. It goes a little something like this.